JBN, we keep you informed. I am Michelle Jones, and in the news, Police High Command expresses condolences to relatives of slain policeman. The Police High Command is expressing sincere condolences to the family, friends, and colleagues of Police Corporal Delwin Jackson, who was one of two shot dead by unknown assailants in Big Lane, Central Village, St. Catherine on Wednesday. Corporal Jackson was assigned to the Glengough Police Station in St. Catherine North Division. Reports are that about 7:15 a.m., residents heard explosions and summoned the police. On the arrival, Corporal Jackson was seen lying on the roadway with multiple gunshot wounds. He was pronounced dead at hospital. The police said a gray Nissan Tita motor car with the engine running was also found at the scene. The area was canvassed, and while processing the scene, the body of 42-year-old Kenroy Chandler, a taxi operator of West Prospect District, Bogwalk, St. Catherine, was found in bushes with gunshot wounds, the police said. It's reported that Corporal Jackson was in the area on personal business, allegedly to purchase a Mark X motor vehicle when he was shot. The forces, chaplaincy, and welfare units are providing support to the family members and colleagues of Corporal Jackson. Meanwhile, the St. Catherine South Police are seeking three men for questioning in connection with the double murder. The three men are known only by their aliases, Bull, Choti, and Tallman. All men are from an area known as Belgium, a police source on the St. Catherine South Police Division said. Man shot dead in Three Miles River, Westmoreland. Gunshots rang out yesterday evening in the community of Three Miles River, leaving one man dead. He has been identified as 25-year-old Michael Curlew, also called Chef, of Telsey Lane in the community. According to a source, Curlew was at one of his usual hangout spots close to his home when a man began shooting before escaping in a waiting motor vehicle. When the chaos subsided, Curlew was seen slumped over and unresponsive. "Nine shot the man getting up," said one resident, who refused to provide a name. "Me dey at a restaurant to buy food and me hear they shot them. Straight face shot." Curlew's father, sorrowful resident, said, lost his life in a similar manner a few years ago. Yesterday's death marks the third shooting murder within the space of 7 days in the Frome Division. Bridge collapses at Manchester Trelawney border. Scores of residents have been cut off from crossing the Manchester Trelawney border on the Oxford to Troy main road after a bridge collapsed on Wednesday afternoon. Member of Parliament for Manchester Northwestern, Michael Phillips, said that the bridge collapsed shortly after 4 p.m. He said the National Works Agency has been made aware of the incident. "It is a bridge that divides South Trelawney and Northwest Manchester. I have contacted the NWA. I know they went up there to look at it," he said by telephone. "They are looking at it as a matter of urgency. We just have to wait, and by tomorrow, I'll be able to have more information on it," he added. He said if the bridge isn't replaced soon, it will cause inconvenience for students when schools reopen next month. "If it is not dealt with by the time for back to school, we have students who leave from there and go to Balaclava High that would be affected. It would affect those who would leave there and go to Santa Cruz, Mile Gully, and Mandeville," he said. "It is shorter to traverse there to Mandeville than to go to Christian and then Mandeville," said Phillips. Five males fatally shot. Indicom launches probe. The Independent Commission of Investigations, Indicom, responded to and began investigations into four separate fatal shooting incidents by the police on Monday, August 16, 2021. These incidents resulted in the death of five males, two teenagers, and three adults, and the alleged recovery of four firearms at the incident scenes. The hands of each deceased man were swabbed for gunshot residue. All police officers involved in the four incidents have provided initial accounts to Indicom investigators and were issued Section 21 notices to furnish a statement and attend the offices of Indicom this week, where they will be interviewed in relation to their respective incidents. The police have reported to Indicom that three officers were on patrol duties in Central Village when the team received a radio transmission regarding gunshots in the Big Lane area. It is alleged that two men were seen who fired at the police, and the police officers then fired in the direction of the men. One male was found suffering from gunshot wounds and was pronounced dead at the Spanish Town Hospital, while the other male is reported as having escaped. The deceased has been identified as 16-year-old Giovanni Johnson. One firearm, a .38 revolver with a serial number, was reported as recovered from the incident scene. The scene was processed by Indicom, and the weapons of the officers, as well as the recovered firearm, were boxed and sealed for testing at the government forensic lab. The police have stated that a team of three police officers were on foot patrol in the community of Gardner Land, Orokabesa, St. Mary, when there was an exchange of gunfire between the police unit and a man seen on a veranda of a dwelling. It is alleged that the man ran into the house and the exchange of gunfire continued. Two men were subsequently found inside the house with gunshot injuries and were pronounced dead at the Port Maria Hospital. The deceased males have been identified as 19-year-old Damario Sanders and 24-year-old Ramon Chin. A 9mm Browning pistol with serial number was reported as recovered from one of the deceased. The incident scene, weapons of the police officers, and the recovered gun were processed by Indicom. The police have reported that officers were on mobile patrol when they were advised of gunshots in the vicinity of Burger Gully. The officers reported that upon arrival at the location, men fired at them, and in response, the police officers fired in the direction of the men. One man who was found to be suffering from gunshot injuries was transported to the Kingston Public Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. The deceased has not been identified. The incident scene, to include two vehicles reportedly damaged during the exchange of gunfire, was processed by Indicom. The weapons of the officers, as well as the recovered firearm, a 9mm pistol with serial number, were boxed and sealed for testing at the government forensic lab. The police have reported that five police officers were in pursuit of men who ran onto a premises with an unfinished structure. There was an alleged exchange of gunfire between at least one man and the police officers. A man was subsequently found with gunshot wounds inside the dwelling and was pronounced dead at the Kingston Public Hospital. A Glock with serial number was reported as recovered from the deceased. At this time, the deceased male is officially unidentified. The incident scene, weapons of the police officers, and the recovered firearm were processed by Indicom. Indicom reminds the public that it is important for persons with information to contact our head office and assist with these investigations. All initial accounts provided by the police to Indicom are preliminary reports and will be subjected to all the requisite investigative and forensic examination. Wholeness saddened at passing of attorney, former MP Ernest Smith. Prime Minister Andrew Holness today expressed sadness at the passing of attorney-at-law Ernest Smith. The 70-year-old, who is a former Jamaica Labour Party JLP St. Anne Southwest Member of Parliament, reportedly passed away at the University Hospital of the West Indies about 9 p.m. on Wednesday after a battle with cancer. Holness, in a Facebook post on Wednesday, said that he was saddened to learn of the passing of Smith, who was popularly known by the nickname Ernie. Ernest Smith was a prominent lawyer, former member of the Jamaica Labour Party, and a member of Parliament for Southwest St. Anne, which he served for two consecutive terms between 2002 and 2011, wrote Holness. I express heartfelt condolences to his wife, children, including our own state minister in the Ministry of Finance and the Public Service, and a member of Parliament for North East St. Anne, Marshall Smith, and the rest of his family, as they mourn this tremendous loss, he added. Smith is survived by widow Lynette Roy Smith, a son, and four daughters. Scatterborough says COVID is real. Scatterborough says his thoughts on the COVID-19 virus have taken a complete 360-degree turn. The producer, who caught the virus late last month, said that contrary to his original thought, the virus is not a common cold and should be taken seriously. To be honest, me never take me cold and catch this thing. Me think this thing was like a common cold where anybody could and catch. But me think say my immune system was so strong that it wouldn't overlook me, he shared. Adding that he thought it would be asymptomatic. Me think say if me did catch it, me won't show any signs. But COVID is not just a simple disease. When you leave your body and you go back and get a negative test, it takes something away from you. You don't feel like your normal self. Your mind at times feel like you want to play tricks upon you, like someone alien to invade your body. We have to take it serious. It's not just a normal illness, he said. Recalling all the symptoms he experienced, Scatter said that at times he felt he was close to death. He said there were moments when breathing became so difficult he could feel his lungs empty. when the shortness of breath come, I had numerous episodes when I was unable to breathe. I was coughing a lot, and when the coughing get worse, I have never in my life pulled in for oxygen and it was never available. The first couple times it happened to me, I got small panic attacks, he said. Boris said he felt the symptoms before getting tested. I got tested on Thursday, July 29th, but I was feeling symptoms 2 days prior to that. My joints started to feel stiff. I was having a nauseated feeling, and then at times I realized that I was sweating. The chills came after that along with a fever. I got every symptom that was aligned with COVID. Diarrhea, the headaches, shortness of breath, coughing, the loss of smell, loss of taste and appetite. It was really bad, he said. Having survived the illness, Boyle considers himself lucky and is now sending a warning to his colleagues in the industry who still do not believe the virus exists. While he remains unvaccinated and does not intend to change that status, the producer expressed that because of the virus's high mortality rate, persons should be more cognizant of spreading anti-COVID propaganda. A lot of people are against COVID and they are being very protective of themselves. They don't go anywhere and they don't interact with people. And because they're not catching it, they think they're above it. It's not right for them to disperse this anti-COVID information because they are not out there every day with regular persons, he said. You cannot be in a safe space and speaking against COVID like it doesn't exist. We're not immune to this thing. It will and can affect anybody. Up to the biggest advocate against COVID, it can and will affect you. 555 new COVID cases, 3 more deaths. Jamaica recorded 555 new COVID-19 cases on Wednesday, bringing the total number of confirmed cases to 59,932. The country also recorded 3 additional deaths, bringing the death toll to 1,342. According to the Minister of Health and Wellness, the deaths, which occurred on Tuesday, August 17, included a 60-year-old woman from Kingston and St. Andrew, a 94-year-old man from St. Thomas, and a 53-year-old woman from Clarendon. The cases were recorded in St. Catherine, 90, Kingston and St. Andrew, 81, St. Thomas, 55, St. James, 54, Manchester, 53, Westmoreland, 41, Trelawney, 35, Clarendon, 34, St. Elizabeth, 32, Portland and St. Anne, 24 each, St. Mary, 17, and Hanover, 15. The country also recorded 29 recoveries, bringing the total number of recoveries to 47,599. JBN, we keep you informed. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.